Hello there. Today we are going to make a knot on a pencil, and for that we are going to use Puppet Warp in Photoshop. Let's go directly to the amazing tool Puppet Warp. We choose a mesh with more points for greater flexibility and rigid mode, so we don't accidentally inflate our pencil like a balloon. Puppet Warp works that way that you use pins to stretch the mesh. For turning a pin, press Alt or Option on a Mac and turn outside the center of the pin. If you stay directly on the pin and press Alt or Option, you will delete the pin. Now it's a matter of keeping the rounded shape. We want to avoid too much bending and sharp angles, only nice curves. It's a tool that needs a little practice, but it's actually pretty organic in the way it moves. When I'm stretching, I try to be in control of the bending all the time, and very often go back a little. I stretch, go back a little, stretch, go back, and so on until I have my desired shape. It's also better to have fewer pins and let Photoshop do the work. Let's zoom in for more detailed adjustments. I use my arrow keys to reposition my pins in this state. A little up. And down here. Just a little. If we uncheck Show Mesh, it's much easier to see the shape, and we now have to address the pin depth. What should be in front of what? We need a high pin depth in the top here. The Puppet Warp output will be on a single layer, and there's no going back later. Sometimes you need to click many times to get the right depth, or add a pin only for the sake of pushing it up or down. Some final adjustments and press OK. Now I will rotate my pencil for a horizontal position. This needs to be my front image later on. Let's zoom in. It's time to get rid of the white edges. You can't just fix it in the mask as usually, because we only have one layer. But you have to begin with the mask. I select all the black lines with my lasso tool, my polygonal lasso tool to be more precise. Like that. And fill it with white. Now the best way for fixing the white is actually the good old clone stamp tool. If your sampling point is just outside the white area, your color will be just perfect. For the straight lines, make a point, hold shift and a new point, and the line between the two will be repaired. Let's zoom out to check. Well, we have some issues in the bending. We go to Liquify, and now we can push around pixels for a nicer curve. Only small corrections is needed. like that. And hit OK. This is a zoom level of 400%, and it's sometimes easier to do some additional cleaning, even though I have a shaky hand. Well, I know I have done things a little bit difficult for myself this time, with so poor resolution. The outside of the pencil I clean with a black brush in the mask. Using a pen and a tablet is definitely easier than using a mouse for precise work like this. Again, straight lines I'll fix with black dots and pressing shift and another dot. We have to turn the light so it all comes from the same direction in our new bended version. I use pen tool to make my selection. Save the path, go to fly out menu and make a selection. Never mind the feather, we adjust that later. I choose a hue saturation adjustment layer, pull up the brightness and saturation. With a soft brush, I can now feather the light. Like that. I have to fix the part in the middle here. I can use a hard black brush or play it safe with the selection first. I use my polygonal lasso tool and a black brush. I missed a spot. We do the same again. Save the path, go to fly out menu and make a selection. We use hue saturation again. Let's zoom out and soften the light with a big soft brush. Like that. This looks fine. We continue all the way around to add light to the pencil. Pen tool again. Save the path. Go to fly out menu and make a selection. We now have to add shadows where the pencil intersects. I use a simple brightness adjustment layer. Turning the mask to black with Command-I or Control-I on a PC. Use a white soft brush to add shadows. For the areas where you don't want shadow, I use a hard black brush. To jump between black and white, simply press X. I lower my opacity on the brush to even out my very visible transitions. Now some feathering of all the light surfaces. a little light on the eraser and the tip of the pencil, and we are almost done. I now crop my image for the aspect ratio of a YouTube video so I can make a front image for this tutorial. And I move my pencil to make room for a title and press OK. Now it's time to find a color for the background. I'll go for a complementary color, pale blue. And a drop shadow, also in a bluish gray color. This color, maybe this. Yes, this is fine. And hit OK. I just play around with distance, size and opacity until I think it looks good. When we zoom in, I can see we missed some edges in our refinement. It's very visible with the new and darker background. Well, now I have cleaned up the image a little bit more, and here is the final result. I really hope you liked this tutorial. If you did, please like, subscribe, leave a comment, or ring that bell for future notifications. Thank you and goodbye.